Hello, my name is Kyoko Hamilton. I'm a Japanese and I grew up in a very devout Buddhist family in a town outside of Tokyo. My mother attended a Catholic school for a brief period and she told me that the Christian God was Jesus Christ and that he was hung on the cross. That was all I ever knew of Christianity as I grew up. During the Korean War, many American soldiers were stationed in Japan. And when I was 20 years old, I married one against my parents' wishes. My husband and I came to Chicago in 1955 to make what I thought would be our new happy home. I thought that I should follow the religion of my husband. And since America is a Christian country, I wanted to become a Christian. However, I soon discovered that my husband was not a real Christian. When we moved to Chicago, my husband became a policeman, and I stayed home to learn how to cook and learn English. Throughout this time, I wanted to be a Christian, but I did not know how to pray to the Christian God. One day on Easter Sunday, I saw a Bible story in newspaper that has the Lord's Prayer. So I memorized that prayer and prayed it every day, although I did not understand what I was praying. All I knew was that Jesus was the Christian God. My interest in Christianity grew, but my husband did not let me go to the church. He did not even want me to go out during the day. At the time, I believed that he was protecting me since I did not know my way around Chicago or what bus to take. One day, while my husband was patrolling on the street, a woman sold him a King James Bible for $1, and he brought it home to me. I felt tremendous joy in my heart, and the Bible became my most precious gift. During the first 2 or 3 years of marriage, my husband took me to the dance hall, but did not want me to associate with the other Japanese wives. So I felt very isolated. I wrote to my parents, but I couldn't tell them what my life was like. Instead, I told them that I was a happy married homemaker in Chicago. My daily routine became reading the King James Bible. Whenever I got homesick or sad, I would open the Bible and read. In 1966, after I gave birth to my first son, my husband became more difficult and our relationship grew worse. In 1969, when I was pregnant with our second son, he asked me for a separation because he was involved with another woman. It was a complete shock to me. I never expected that. I told him that we had a son and another soon to be born. They deserved to be raised by both parents. I gave him permission to see the woman with whom he was involved, but I did not divorce him. We lived separately in the same house, and I gave birth to our healthy second son. When my second son started elementary education, I enrolled as a nursing student at Chicago State University. My husband didn't want me to go to school, so I had to get up at night studying. At times, I even had to go to friends' home so I could continue school. In my third year of nursing school, I was divorced from my husband. I was then a single mom raising my two sons, but I felt that God was helping me because my English was good enough to get into school. After the divorce, someone invited me to their Baptist church, and I learned there were other translations of the Bible. My desire to become a Christian grew, but there were so many things about faith I did not understand. Although I went to the church and kept reading my Bible, I didn't understand why the Christian God was on the cross. Nobody in church told me why Christ was on the cross, and I didn't understand why Jesus had to die for my sins. I started reading Our Daily Bread, and the third page that year told of a family who read the Bible from beginning to end. I thought that was a good idea, so I started to read in Genesis. When I came to Leviticus, I read how an animal had to be sacrificed for sins, and my eyes are opened, and I understood for the first time. I understood why Jesus was called the Lamb of God. Then, finally, it made sense, and I was overwhelmed with the truth that Jesus died for my sins. That was when I really became a Christian. Until then, I had read and believed that Jesus was God and knew something about the Trinity, but I didn't know why Jesus died. I began looking for a class that taught the Bible, and I heard about the precept class that meet on Tuesday here at the Moody Church. So I started to attend that class in 2005, but it was 2 years later that I decided to visit Moody Church on Sunday. I attended a membership class and became a member in November of 2007. I joined the choir and have been involved in the church ever since. After I accepted Christ, I began looking for a way to share the love of Jesus with others. One day, I saw a Japanese woman making beautiful cards out of white boxes, and she sent them all over the world to encourage people not to clutter the earth by throwing things away, but to use these materials to make something beautiful. That inspired me to make bookmarks and use them to spread the gospel. In 2005, I began to make embellishments using only things that were going to be thrown out, with a scripture verse on the back. I have given away about 300, mostly to strangers, to give me the opportunity to tell them the gospel. I call them born again bookmarks, and I explain how I make them from things that people throw away. But even though I saved these bookmarks from being trashed, eventually, they will fall apart. However, when Jesus gives us new birth, we are truly born again, and He will never let us fall apart. He takes what seemed like garbage and makes it beautiful again.